Thank you, all the organizers. And it is my duty now to somehow close this conference and say a few words. But we agreed with Jan that instead of saying a conclusion, we would like to ask the speakers, and if possible, I would like to ask later on two or three from the audience, just to say, not in more than 1 minute, a take-home message. So what is the take-home message, in your opinion, of this meeting? Giacomo, we start with you. A take-home message.
Well, my wish would be that all this cognitive stuff that we learned, and some was extremely fascinating, like the talk of Stan, would be really linked to real physiology and anatomy. Otherwise, I feel there is a kind of gap between a wonderful experiment and a rather mysterious anatomy.
Okay, Frederick, you're next.
Wow, well, I think it's very stimulating to see that the sort of bridge between the two worlds, humanities and natural sciences, are being built sort of both here and at home in in Europe. So I'm looking forward to further interactions with you.
Well, I was very impressed by the multimodal and cross-discipline approach. People use very different methods, different model systems, basic cellular mechanisms, and complex brain systems and brain physiology, and also more experimental psychology. And so I was, I like the width of the different approaches and ways of thinking. I thought that was very stimulating.
Go over to Guy.
I have a very simple summary, Balázs. You did a wonderful job. See you next time.
Yeah, really, backing up what Guy said, thank you very much. It was a wonderful experience. And if you want to hear my worries, I still think that we have a huge gap to close between all the detailed knowledge we have about microcircuits, neurons, connectomes, and on the other side, the sophisticated behavior and the psychological descriptions. The machinery in between, to me at least, is still by and large enigmatic. So invite us back in 2 years and we will show you the progress.
Thank you. I was really struck by Sid Brenner's wonderfully young presentation, saying that the human brain is special and we need to study the human brain. And I think we're seeing a lot of progress in this bridging process. But since we are at a technological university, I would invite people to help us develop better technologies. I completely agree with Giacomo. We need to bridge the gap by going all the way to circuits and eventually individual neurons. And it can be done, but we need help to study the human brain specifically because it has all these wonderfully special functions.
Thank you. Torkel, you are nearest. So.
Thanks a lot for organizing this, Balázs. It was a pleasure. And one of the concepts was bridges between, for example, Western and East, but I enjoyed the bridge between different perspectives from the cellular to the systems level and the imaging. So I learned a lot. I enjoyed it.
Thank you. Ernst?
I think the question of a take-home message is a typical Western question and does not apply to the Eastern way. So I would leave it. There are many, if you want to, messages, take-home messages, but it's typical, I think, to bridge. We should leave it, in my words, in a state of indefiniteness or multivariate. Yeah. Thank you.
Peter?
So enormous challenges remain. We better get busy and get back to work as soon as possible. But the notion that we know an enormous lot about circuits is a rubber neuron illusion.
Atsushi?
Uh, you gave me a tough burden. I'm only Eastern origin speaker among the 15 speakers. And if there's a comment, I think I have to comment on the East-West connections perspective. And there are three points I think we have to be aware of. One is that natural science is definitely a Western culture, and which is very much successful and still is successful for recent 300 years or so. But being the Easterners, having 3,000 years of background, we cannot escape from that, but still have to establish in the Western culture. So probably the most, when as a minority in the Western culture, and for people who is trying to do that, they tend to be extreme fundamentalist. So probably the Easterners in working in the science tends to be implicitly extremely West, and that we have to be aware to ask for their comments, including myself. And the next, second one is that the view of the East we heard during this meeting was Western view of the East, like indefiniteness. If you start from, say, the modern pragmatism definition of something and ask for the Eastern view, there's always indefinite and ambiguous. But from the Eastern point of view, to view the West, it is very much limited, and there's much more broad unknowns outside, and there's no word to define it. So probably this is kind of the Eastern view of the West, and I think that's to solve that, to unify that both view will extremely benefit both of us. And finally, related to this is that to communicate between East and West, we have to communicate in English, which is a Western language, and have a Western vocabulary, the Western grammatical structure. And to understand Eastern way of thinking, which has many concepts that cannot be explained or having even words in the Western culture. And that has to be very much aware from the both sides, especially from the extreme fundamental Westerners of the Easterners, to discuss this in English is a very difficult task. And I would like to ask the Westerners to be very much tolerant and inclusive for this point of view. The three points that I was wondering during all throughout the conference.
Thank you. Is there anyone here from our speakers who hasn't spoken? If not, I think just two or three opinions from the audience, but just to keep the gender balance, let's ask ladies. Annabel.
Well, from all the talks I've heard, I think that they've been wonderful and very enriching. Definitely very different views from cellular all the way to then functional applications. And yeah, I do agree there's still a huge gap over there. But on the other hand, there's also a huge gap from even just the functional to applications. So in terms of East and West, I think one of the things that we've learning is like there's a lot of progress and developments in the West in some of these ideas. Similarly, in the East, I guess in the more recent years, there are developments as well, and from many different aspects. Language is one of the very obvious difference in development, and there's always the question of this language itself. As a culture, develop a different brain that is looking at things or giving perspectives that are different between different cultures, and thus inherently impact the structures of the brain itself. But just from today's talk, there are many different perspectives. You can look at math, and math, whether it's a language or not, I mean, that's from the Eastern standpoint, it may be quite different in view of what is mathematical reasoning in itself, and also even in body perception. I think that's really interesting. Thank you.
Thank you. So let's choose a lady. Which lady from this court is ready to speak? Lady, are you ready to hear something? Just your opinion.
What is the take-home message?
Actually, I'm not in this area. I'm a civil engineer. So it's an eye-opening for me, and I learn a lot of things. But I think I would like to see more application, because I'm an engineer, application of all this, yeah. So I hope in the future talk about more about applications. Yes.
Thank you. And from this side, Helen.
Thank you, Balázs. All the talks are very interesting. I only did one study on ERP 10 years ago, and at that time we tried to see whether there are any differences, any changes in the brain after meditation. And our data show that it's not possible to see the results using ERP. So with this EEG technique, I believe all these studies are really inspiring. And I have been conducting behavioral studies, testing children on the acquisition of physical action verbs. And so the last speaker's talk is very interesting to me, because I want to see whether children could imitate physical action verbs, and also whether they could, whether it's related to their acquisition of the type of verbs, both in English and in Chinese. So the focus is on bilingual development. So conferences like this, each time, give us lots of different ways of thinking about our human body and reality. So thank you very much for the organizers and speakers.
Thank you, Helene. And with this, let me give the mic to my sparring partner, Jan Vasbinder, to say the closing words.
It's over. I don't want to say much, actually. I thought about summarizing the whole thing and keep you here for another half hour, but there's really two people that I want to mention. One is on the other side of the door who doesn't want to come in. Actually, she doesn't want me to use her name, but this conference would not have happened if it were not for Karen. So if you give a very loud applause, she may hear it on the other side. And then, of course, the other person is Balázs, who I think he's already been thanked, but I think you did a most fantastic job in moderating this conference. And also, without Balázs, this conference would not have happened. We would not have had the people to come and the enthusiasm to radiate. So thank you very much. We'll go for another conference in the near future and some other interesting projects. And no, I think I'll stick to this one. There's a lot to say about the next conference, but that would take me 15 minutes, and I will not do this. So thank you very much for coming, the audience and the speakers and all the help, the gentleman over there, the lady over there, and all the others that helped in the audience, or helped to carry around this microphone. That's it. Welcome home. I mean, get back home, have a good trip home, and see you the next time.